Hello everyone, this is Mohammed from RubyMaroc. Today I will be making this short video as a break of our series, and I will explain some differences between REST and in JSON API. Saying REST, I mean the typical REST API, which returns single objects only, and the JSON API, I refer to the implementation of the JSON API specifications. To explain the differences, I will be using this example. For example, if we want to display a blog post page, we should retrieve all this information, for example, the post data, then the author data, and then the comments with the users who wrote the these comments. For the REST API, we expect that the user will fetch the post data. In our case, for example, we send this request to our API, then we get this response with the post data, for example, title and the body and the published date and the number of comments, and then author ID and probably more other data that we will not need in the client. Once we get the author ID, we make another request to the API with the author ID to get the information of the author. In our case is name and avatar, and again probably some more data that we won't need. Third, we make a request to get all the comments. And once we get the comments, we collect the user IDs of these comments, and we make another fourth request to get this author's data. Yeah, it's true that sometimes we can include some relationship data. For example, here we could include the author data in the first request. Here as well we could include the data of the user who commented in each comment. But if we have like same user made many comments, so we will have like kind of duplicate user data in our response. In general, JSON API solve many issues that we could have in our REST API. So we could do the exact same thing using JSON API. Just by calling one request with the post ID, then we specify which relationships we have to include in the response. So in our case, we'll include the author, the comments, and then the user who wrote the comments. And we could also improve this query by sparsing the exact attributes or the exact fields that we have that we need in our page. For example, we want to fetch only the title, the body, the published date, the comments count. For the author, we could fetch only the name, avatar, profile URL. For the comments, only the body and the creation date, and for the user, only the name and avatar. And very importantly, to not forget the relationships keys in the sparse fields. That's because you want to include them here in the relationships. So the response is gonna be like that. So here we have like three sections. The first one is the data of the resource, then the links, and then the included section, which specify the relationships. So here we have the ID and the type of this post, and then the attributes, and then the relationships. We have like author with the ID and type and comments. We have also an array of comments with ID and type, and here we have like some kind of links, and at the end you have like included section, which contain the data of this relationship. So we have like author, comments, and comments has a relationships with this user, and here we have the data of this user. To summarize, let's compare some of the features of both APIs. First, to fetch multiple data objects in a single response. Yeah, you can achieve that in both approaches. Second, if you want to embed related data, for example, the author of each article, as we say, that you can achieve that as well with REST. But when it becomes to in terms of performance, for example, in our example, if you want to fetch like authors, then the comments, then the users who commented the comments, we might have some duplicate objects, and which will lead to a long response. So JSON API definitely solved this problem using the included section in the response. Here, if you want to fetch only the needed fields of a data object, of course we can't achieve that using REST, but we can do using JSON API. In terms of fetching data, if you want to filter by some fields, you will need to implement that for REST API, but using JSON API you don't need to make any changes in the API. You can filter by some fields and do sorting and etc. Regarding pagination, of course you have to implement it for REST, but it comes by default for JSON API. Regarding caching, it's not a big issue. It should work well for both of them. And regarding writing data, it's very easy to create and update data. In terms of bulk operation, REST API, it doesn't support that. But for JSON API, it's coming soon. There is an extension for bulk operations. And for configuration, for me, it's easy to install and configure for both APIs. Yeah, lastly, you can have the auto-generated documentation using Swagger, for example. So you can achieve that in both in REST and in the JSON API. Interactivity is very poor in REST APIs, where navigable links are rarely available, while JSON API provide the links in its response, which enable exploration of the API. As we saw in the example before, for validatable and programmable schema, you can also achieve that using a third-party solution as the auto-generated documentation. Having said all of that, I personally would rank JSON API above REST. I really like it. It solves many of our issues. Yeah, you can have a look at it in the official website of JSON API, and you can also look for some client and server libraries and try it out. Also, you can have a look at this talk of Marco. He tells his experience with JSON API. He make a little comparison between JSON API and GraphQL. We didn't cover GraphQL yet, that we will do in the next episodes. So we will see the differences between JSON API and GraphQL as well. Yeah, that's it for this episode. I hope it was useful and you have a better overview about REST API and JSON API. Yeah, I hope you like it, and see you in the next one.